Density is one of the most important things we can measure about a planet. It's the key thing that tells us what a planet is made of. So the values we calculate for density are going to be important for several future assignments. We're calculating the densities of planets in this assignment. Density is defined as the mass divided by the volume. More generally, the density of a planet depends mostly on what it's made of. A high-density planet will typically be made of materials like rock and metal, while a lower density usually means the composition is mostly liquid hydrogen and helium or hydrogen compounds like water and methane. The only values this question gives you are the ranges of typical densities of materials, so you should write these in here. While you won't be using these numbers in the calculation, they will be important for helping you interpret your results and deciding if your answers make sense. The prediction in this question is simpler than some of the others. You're just being asked which of two planets is likely to have the higher density. In general, people focus on the mass, the radius, or the location of the planet to determine which should be more dense. You can also compare to densities of planets in our own solar system to decide what will be most important. The key thing to remember here is that your prediction should have a Y component to it. You need to make it clear which piece of information you're basing your prediction on. Also remember that if it turns out that the prediction is wrong, you can correct it in the comparison part of the question. The equation for density is very simple. Density equals mass divided by volume. However, since volume isn't given in your mystery solar system table, you're going to need to add in the formula for the volume of a sphere. As it says in the question, volume equals 4 pi r cubed divided by 3. In this case, r is the radius of the planet. So you're going to need two sets of numbers from the mystery solar system table, the masses and radii of the largest inner and outer planets. We're going to do something a little different with the unit conversion this time. Generally, we list density in units of grams per centimeter cubed. Normally, that would mean turning the mass of the planet into grams and the radius into centimeters. However, that would involve taking several steps in doing the conversion. So instead, we're going to convert the mass and radius into kilograms and meters, which we've already done before, so we know how to do. This will give us a density in kilograms per meter cubed instead. At the end of the calculation, we'll do one more conversion to turn the density into grams per cubic centimeter. So at the moment, let's convert the mass and radius. We'll use the same values we saw in a previous question, a planet with a mass of 0.5 Earth masses and a radius of 0.8 Earth radii. We've done these conversions before, so you should check that you see how we get these values. Remember that the values of one Earth mass and one Earth radius are given on your mystery solar system table. When we get to the end of the problem, we'll need to convert the answer to grams per cubic centimeter. So let's write that conversion down here. 1 gram per cubic centimeter equals 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter. So when we finish the calculation, we'll need to multiply by 1 gram per cubic centimeter divided by 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter to get the answer in the right units. We'll do the density calculation in a couple of parts. First, we'll figure out the planet's volume. Then we'll use that to calculate the density. Remember, at the end, we'll need to do the conversion to grams per cubic centimeter. We set up the volume formula again, this time with the value of the radius included. First, we should cube the radius, which also cubes the units. Notice that the exponent is now just over 3 times the value it had before. When we cube a number, we multiply the exponent by 3. We finish the volume calculation by multiplying by 4 pi divided by 3. Next, we calculate the density by dividing mass by volume. In general, you should get a density in the hundreds to thousands of kilograms per cubic meter here. If it's outside that range, you should go back and check the calculation, especially the volume, since that's the most complex part of the calculation. Finally, we convert the density to grams per cubic centimeter by multiplying by 1 gram per cubic centimeter divided by 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter. Note that there is one extra step in this question. You need to describe what composition this density implies. As we've already seen, planets with densities between 4 and 6 grams per cubic centimeter, like the one in our example, are probably made mostly of rock and metal. On the other hand, planets with densities between 0.5 and 2 grams per cubic centimeter are mostly less dense materials like liquid hydrogen, helium, and hydrogen compounds. If the density is between 2 and 4 grams per cubic centimeter, then that suggests comparable amounts of both high and low density materials. We will use the results of these calculations in several later assignments, so I recommend keeping a copy of these results where you can get at them both in and out of class. Once again, you should look over your results and decide if your answers make sense and if they match your predictions. It's not unusual for students to be surprised by the results of their calculations, so if you learn something new about where different types of planets are located in your mystery solar system, then you should say that here. Note that if your answers are well outside of the range, 0.5 to 6 grams per cubic centimeter, then it's probably telling you there's a mistake in the calculation. You should check your calculation steps, and if you're stuck, feel free to ask for help. If it's too late to ask, make sure you at least explain why you think there's a problem with the answer. And of course, if everything checks out okay, make sure you say that as well.